When of Loxley survived the burning sands of faraway lands as he served his role in the Unforgiving Crusades. He emerged unscathed from deadly skirmishes just to become an exile and face mightier enemies in his own home country. After his previous hideout in Silwich, which was razed to the ground, the Forests of Sherwood granted refuge to him and his retinue, while its new rulers threatened all. King Richard the Lionheart's untimely demise plunged England into chaos and left roving bands and their petty warlords free to fight amongst themselves for territory and influence. The Sheriff of Nottingham, a murderer and usurper, exploiting the pervasive lawlessness, pillages one area after another, increasing his power and leaving the poor residents of Sherwood at the mercy of wild fate.
So what's your take on the best feather for fletching?
No question. Duck feathers. They provide the perfect balance of stability and...
Duck feathers? I've always favored goose feathers for their durability and consistent flight. Durability. Sacrifice speed. Duck off with that extra zip. Ha! Extra zip? We're not racing arrows, my friend. It's about control and accuracy.
Ducks provide just that. You can't deny the precision they offer.
Precision, perhaps. Goose feathers have a more forgiving margin for error.
Ah, forgive me, but I'd rather not make errors in the first place. Duck feathers ensure a clean release every time. Goose feathers can handle changing weather conditions better. Ever shot in the rain? Rain or shine, mine cut through the air like nothing else.
Well, I appreciate consistency.
Goose feathers provide that reliable, steady flight. Reliability is overrated when you can have speed, precision. Until you're
caught in a gusty crosswind.
Goose feathers handle it better. Agree to disagree. When you're aiming for the bullseye, you'll wish you had duck feathers guiding you.
Good business to you.
Thank you. I always worry when you're away from home for long, Robin.
My good friar, the sheriff will face death well before I do.
Haughty as always, I'm just glad to see you in good health, friend.
Don't worry. We're not in danger this time. We're safe here.
Nothing I can do after the nightmare that the Crown's men brought on us and our old home.
This time they won't run into us. We're well hidden. I saw to that.
The previous settlement was so goodly, I know you all too well, you crafty fox. I'm aware you're scheming to fight back.
What matters is everyone made it out alive. After I defeated Black Henry and freed Marion, the sheriff completely lost his composure.
The enemies, the king and sheriff, don't stop at their own henchmen. You constantly hear about ever more scoundrels plaguing the surroundings of not...
King's allies grow in numbers. Some are bought with land assignment, others threatened with death and confiscations. We must weaken the grip of the king and the sheriff if we are to feel safe here.
Definitely, Robin. Recently, Little John had his shirt cut. We can't take risks like that.
He'll recover. You know him. We each have our crosses to bear. You say so yourself.
Well said. You may be right. This settlement seems secure.
This time no one will find us. Time to let an arrow loose right into the beast's heart.
I believe you, dear Robin, but before you do that, you must regain your strength. Setting up a new village is exhausting work. Eat something, have a drink, rest in your home. We'll talk later.
Please, look out for yourself when you're out gathering the herbs.
Very funny. I've been locked in a tower once, and now there's no end to the jokes.
Jokes? Me? My dearest, I'm only a simple outlaw. I know nothing of jokes.
Just like I know nothing of herbs. Come here, simple outlaw. I've missed you.
And I have missed you, Marion.
Going back to your woes, little...
Need something? How's your day, sir?
Have you already managed to get some rest? Good friend, it'll never cease to amaze me how little sleep...
It's good for you, as long as you have water instead of wine, good friar.
I'm not swayed by this, but...
I knew how you'd react. Take it easy, Tuck.
I should think so. It's a strategic reserve for a time of crisis.
Certainly. Not another word.
I take it you slept so well, you misplaced your weapon. Where is your bow?
This time I didn't lose anything. I broke it during a hunt. We've had so much work with building a new village that I haven't had time to craft a new one yet.
The forest hasn't been kind to us of late. The worst is behind us, however, and now you can take to making your bow in peace. Grab a hatchet and fell a few trees. The wood should suffice for both the bow and the arrows. I have a hemp cord here that should do as a bowstring.
That's all the help I need. Thank you, Tuck.
I know how much you value your weapon. See to crafting it, but be right back.
How are you doing? Nice weather we're having.
How have you been getting along with Tuck while I'm away?
Lately, he got the crazy idea of been nicking wine from his pantry.
Well, have you?
Of course I have, but he ain't caught me red-handed. And if he does...
You'll tell him that's not your red hand.
Is there anything you need? Is there anything you need?
What's your take on the best feather for fletching?
No question.
The perfect balance of stability and speed. Duck feathers? I've always favored goose feathers for their durability and consistent flight. Durability, too, but you sacrifice speed. Duck offer that extra zip. Ha!
Extra zip? We're not racing arrows, my friend.
It's about control and accuracy. And ducks provide just that. You can't deny the precision they offer. Precision, perhaps.
Hello. Hello.
With a bow like this, you have nothing to fear. Unless you get on Marion's bad side again by telling her to cook for you. Even the purest steel and holy water wouldn't help you then.
Time's long past. We've explained things to each other and agreed I wouldn't make this mistake again. Speaking of whom, have you seen her anywhere?
Be at ease. This time no one lured her into a trap. She left to help the locals. She'll be back sooner or later.
That sounds like her. You said you could use my help here?
Yes, there are many things we need. Food, most of them all. A better archer couldn't be found in all of Sherwood. Before you set off to take from the rich, perhaps you could use your skills to aid us.
I'll gladly try out the new bow. Stoke the fire. We're having a roast tonight. I'll leave the meat in storage.
Everyone in the village is working so intensely, a small feast should lift their spirits.